What up, what up, y'all? It's Coffee on the Vid, and if y'all listen closely there, if not, you can run it back. You know what I mean? You heard them talking about the chain, as 6ix9ine did this second story stage dive on his first concert in a minute, right, in Orlando. And y'all see all the reports coming out, you know, 6ix9ine concert ends abruptly in Orlando, first show since forever. And, you know, people tried to snatch his chain when he stage dived. Someone snatched his hat. 6ix9ine got all bent out of shape and abruptly ended the show. And we have even seen a dude come out. I mean, he could be fronting. Y'all tap in. Let me know what you guys think. But there's a fan who is saying he indeed has the hat and he wants a stack for it. Will he get it? I don't know. Maybe. Who knows? But you see the way 6ix9ine's telling the story, he's going on social media, posting, flexing. What are they talking about? $100,000 back end on the show. I don't know if I really believe those numbers. Do you? Like, tap in, guys, because peep it. This is 6ix9ine's first show in forever. He's basically a risk for a venue. Like, we've heard stories many times about places having concerts. Certain artists are a risk, you know, because there's insurance and things like that, and people don't want to book them because there could be violence, this, that, and the third. And as we know, 6ix9ine probably's got some kind of bounty on his head out here, and I'm not buying it. That 100K, fuck out of here. And then you'll see he's also saying he not gonna be able to come outside. Jumped in the crowd with all my jewelry on, $2 million worth. Real life, the internet, you know, the whole real life's greater than the internet. If you mad, just say that. Don't at me. And I know everyone's going to say, yo, Coffee, 6ix9ine's a troll. You know this. We know this. The whole world knows this. He's trolling. That's just what he does. But peep it. This is a little more than trolling. And 6ix9ine's been like that from time to time. Emotions actually get involved. We know the dude loves the troll. There's documentaries and video after video out there, you know, highlighting the way he trolls and gets everyone to tune in. But we know those days have kind of pretty much been over with 6ix9ine. Those days are behind him. It's been a minute since he's been a real trending story on the internet. He came home after telling on everyone. And no one really gave a fuck for the most part. I mean, there was some ish he did as far as videos, doing some numbers. We found out about the cheat codes or whatnot. But 6ix9ine, his super duper fame for the most part is behind him. But anyways, a lot of times he really tries to actually like talk some ish on a level like he's proving someone to something to someone or to himself or something. And it's like, we seen this all go down before some years back. I'm sure y'all probably remember. If not, you can go tap in and watch it. Dom Is Live did a video on it. White Mike, you know, formerly of Gulf Coast Epidemic, who's just came back out online. He's back on the scene. He's got a new channel called The Enemy Within. He was the one back then that really got the story going. There, when 6ix9ine was in San Antonio, the Versace boys were on his ass, you feel me? And they ended up getting arrested at the airport, you know? Even with 6ix9ine having goons with him and everything, them dudes got arrested at the airport. They went the 5-0 route. And like I always tell y'all, I'm no tough guy, you know? I'm a family man. I ain't no big gangster. I'm a civilian, but 6ix9ine was rolling with these dudes back then who weren't supposed to be moving like civilians. And we seen a lot of other ish. They did get inactive, but it seems that day when it came to the Versace boys in San Antonio, someone was running to the law. I'm not trying to call Treyway as a whole at like snitches or anything like that, but one way or another, these dudes got arrested. Yeah, they possibly could have told on themselves. Maybe that's what it was, you know, maybe it was the hip hop police and the feds already being all over 6ix9ine and Treyway. I don't know. But anyways, 6ix9ine in San Antonio jumped in the crowd and came back without a chain. We saw the video. And like I said, White Mike was the one who really highlighted it. Dom Is Live took it to the next level and it went crazy viral. 6ix9ine went as far as hitting Dom Is Live up in the DMs. It's all in his video. Like, yo, why you giving these clout chasers life? Why, you know, why this, why that? Why you titling the video that I got my chain snatched? Dom Is Live was more is less like, yo, you got your chain snatched. We seen it on there. You know what I mean? We seen you jump in, come out without it. You were pointing all in the crowd. And a security went and tried to get it back. It is what it is. And this time around, we know 6ix9ine just getting back to doing shows decides to do this reckless stage dive, which, yo, that ish is crazy. That could have really hurt someone. But anyways, we see how it went down. They were trying to snatch the man's chain and hat. Looks like they only came up with a hat. Looks like for the most part, he's got all his jewels still. But for him to get on the internet, get on Instagram, flaunt, like I said, I don't believe the 100K back end. I don't believe it. Maybe I'm tripping. I don't know. Like, that's some serious show money. And I just don't think 6ix9ine is on that kind of level anymore, like I said. And the fact that he needs the venues more than the venues need him right now, if you ask me. I feel like there's a lot of other artists out there that a venue would rather book than 6ix9ine. Not to mention the fact, like I said, about the whole risk factor and insurance and everything like that. But this man trying to talk greasy about this, like, come on, man. You're not tough. You never were tough. Security saved you, which, I mean, we know that's what this is, but he's just trying to flex on everyone. It's really showing how insecure and how much his feelings are hurt at this point. Because let's not forget, when you break it all down, since 6ix9ine has come home, he's pretty much been a failure as far as, if you want to go as far as where the bar was set and how much money was invested in him, he's pretty much failed meeting those expectations. And then, you know what's crazy, right? DJ Academics, as we know, has been 6ix9ine's, you know, BFF and all that for a minute. But Academics at times started kind of keeping it more real and really reporting on what was going on from more of an unbiased perspective. But if you peep this, he's talking about, yo, 6ix9ine just tore it up. His show went phenomenal. It all went to plan. You know, everything went as planned. Where should he go next? Should Rolling Loud book him? Like, Academics is really trying to push this and make this go viral. Like, Rolling Loud? I don't know, y'all. Like, you guys let me know what you think. But you see Ak not mentioning anything about 6ix9ine abruptly ends the show. I mean, come on, guys. We seen the way they got up in there. We seen the way he was having a hissy fit. But Academics, all of a sudden, really advocating hard for 6ix9ine again. Like, come on, Ak. We were feeling when you were starting to keep it more real about the different things going on with 6ix9ine, but now we see you're just trying to push whatever movement he's got going. Like, come on, B. But peep this, you guys. This is his first show back, if he does get booked more places. Because I really think, looking at this, the way that this went, how other venues don't really have, he ain't really a draw like that anymore for them to want to book him. And then, once again, the risk factor. And then they're going to see the footage, the way this went, the reports of him ending the show abruptly. Then think about the goons or whoever's out there that really wants to get at 6ix9ine that are just seeing, oh, he's doing shows again. Because I don't believe this was heavily advertised like that. So if he really is trying to get out there like this, yeah, he's got the security and whatnot. But believe me, these goons, you know what I'm saying? These cats that really want to get at him are going to find a way. You know, we saw what went down when he was doing the hood to hood, disrespecting everyone's hood tour. You know what I'm saying? When he was, what was it, Harlem, where people tried to press him anyways, even with security there. I mean, I don't know, y'all. I think this is just the beginning of more problems for this man. Y'all hit the comments. Let me know what you guys think. Thanks for tuning in. New viewers, it's Jay Coffee Talk. Smash all them buttons. Sub to the channel. We drop content every day. Music, news, sports, and more. I'm gone.